الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
أشهد
أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
حق لا اله الا الله رب ازدعوا التامه والصلاه القائمه على سيدنا محمد البصير افضل وابعث الانقام محمد وعدت انك لا تخفي معاد رسول الله ربنا بالاسلام دينا صلى ان الحمد لله ان الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا انه من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا واشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه أشهد أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة ومحى الغمة وجاهد في الله حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين فصلاةً وسلامًا على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب ومن يتوكل على الله فهو حسبه إن الله بالغ أمره قد جعل الله لكل شيء قدرا. وقال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم ما رؤي الشيطان أصغر ولا أحقر ولا أضحر ولا أغيظ منه في يوم عرفة وما ذلك إلا أن الرحمة تتنزل فيه فيتجاوز عن الذنوب العظام أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. أما بعد All praise to Allah All praise to Allah The one, the only, the one who should be worshipped I bear witness that he is the creator of this universe And he is the one who should be worshipped I bear witness that Muhammad عليه الصلاة والسلام is his messenger True mercy sent to us If you follow his path, inshallah we'll be in Jannah أما بعد Allah is giving us bonus after a bonus, trying to get us and support us. You know, teacher, when he gives you, and he say, tells you, I'll give you a question, but you know, the answer is that answer. And the answer is very simple. And subhanAllah, he wants you to pass. You know, when I was in university, the teacher tells you some of the questions just to elevate your marks. That's it. Anyone who read the book will get the answer. It's that simple. SubhanAllah. Ramadan, we may already gone. Whoever won, won. Whoever lost, lost. May Allah make us all winners. But with that being said, if you have some room for improvement, some way to gain some more, here we go. Next Monday, the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Every one of us know that I give a khutbah. Every all the khutbah said that al-fajr wa layalin ash, all of the 9 days of Dhul Hijjah. There is a hadith saying that this is the best days of the year. There are like I always say, there are days better than days, and nights better than nights, and months better than months. The days better than days is the 10 days of the Hijjah. And definitely the best of them is Yawm Arafah, and I'll talk about it. And nights better than nights, Ramadan. And the best night, the night of power, Laylatul Qadr. Months better than months, Ramadan. Better than all the months and so on. You have to try to get on one of these bonuses. Now, with that being said, this is the night, this is the day. I'll talk about Arafah today. I'm not talking about the 10 days. But just for your knowledge, the 10 days, hopefully they will start this Monday. This Monday they will start and the Eid will be Wednesday, as far as we know until now. Inshallah, 99%. We'll see what will happen next.
But inshallah, next week we will tell exactly where and how we're going to pray, inshallah. Now, with that being said, you see that people are going to Hajj and everyone is standing in Arafah. Wallahi, if you go there, beautiful, everyone wearing white, and hundreds and millions of people are standing in one place praying to Allah to forgive. And subhanAllah, especially in the sun, you feel that, okay, I can run under a tent. I have an umbrella. I can get some water, cold water. I don't know if you have been there or not, but when you're looking badly for a cup of water, cold water, I was trying my best. With that being said, in the hereafter, there is no shade. There is nowhere to hide. And there is no cold water. Then what should we do? We should prepare for that day. This reminds you of that day a little bit. Then, the first difference is no one will be shaded in that day. When I'm talking that day means the hereafter, except under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And definitely, if you want to be shaded under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, anyone can do it. Yes. Seven categories. Seven, the easiest one. If you love someone in the sake of Allah, you want to meet him in the mosque, you want to talk to him, very simple. When you see him, you smile. You tell him that I want to take you with me to Jannah. Both of us will go to Jannah. Have this in your head, wallahi. It will work very good. Now, in the hereafter, Allah will say, أين المتحاب... This is the hadith, أين المتحابون بجلالي يوم... يوم... اليوم أضلهم في ظلي. Where is the people who love me in the sake of Allah? Now, I'll shade them under my shade. When the sun was almost a mile up your head. Now, you know, everyone, the sun is almost how far? 93 million miles. 93 million miles. And we cannot handle the sun. Especially if you go to the Kaab, Mecca, it's very hot there. In noontime, I don't know how can they handle. It's very hot. SubhanAllah, and 93 million miles. SubhanAllah, how about it's above us 1 mile? What we're going to do? SubhanAllah. This is Arafah. Everyone is united. Everyone in the world is united on that day. Everyone is watching. His relatives, his friends, his people are going there to perform Hajj. Then everyone is connected. This is very important to know that we are all, even though our origins are different, but still we're going to the same place. We have to know that. What should we? They are lucky, alhamdulillah. They went there. They, inshallah, will be forgiven. Inshallah, they are bestowed by the mercy of Allah. What about us here? Can we join? Can we share a little bit? We need to share, right? Yes, we can. How? First, do extra good deeds in these 10 days. I'm talking about Arafat now only. Extra good deeds, especially from starting morning immediately. You pray extra sunnah. You try to give on that day. What else? And that day, if you fast that day, Arafat, if you fast that day, it's equal to 2 years. Last week, Sheikh Najat was here, and the first time I heard that he's saying not only he forgives what's past, last year, it forgives what you didn't do yet. What you didn't do. This is the only ibadah that forgives what you didn't do. I haven't heard about ibadah that will forgives what's coming. All the ibadah forgives what passed. Everything you did. Any sins you did. Except that one. The hadith said, يُكَفِّرُ سَنَةً مَاضِيَ وَسَنَةً بَقِيَ. Last year and this year. I didn't finish this year yet. But still, it forgives. Then what should you do? Try to fast on Tuesday. Look at this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودِ فَعَنْ أَبِي هُرَيْرَةَ عَنِ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال اليوم الموعود يوم القيامة والمشهود يوم عرفة والشاهد يوم الجمعة. In the beginning of Surah Al-Buruj, that Allah is saying about السَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ, this is the hereafter. Abu Huraira is saying to the Prophet that this is the hereafter. This is Yawm Arafah. When you go there, this is Yawm, everyone is watching. And Shahidun wa Mashhud, this is Yawm Al-Jum'ah. Okay. Like I said, everyone is trying to aim for ليلة القدر. Everyone of us, try your best. Last 10 days, do it. Come and pray sunnah. But still, you don't know. You don't know when did you do it. But Yom Arafah is known to everyone. No one, everyone. It's Tuesday until today. We'll see, inshallah, next Tuesday, which is the 27th. I'm giving you dates. We know it. Then what should you do? Extra. Do it. Try your best. Try your best to get it. 2 years of hasanah. When I say 2 years, does this include Laylatul Qadr? Why not? It includes Laylatul Qadr. It includes the hasanat in any time. It's 2 years. Allah, the Prophet said 2 years. Sanatan madiya wa sanatan baqiya. Oh, bonus. And always when I say that to the youth or everyone, it's tiring. I cannot fast that day. I cannot do extra work. If any one of you is working in corporation and they tell you a bonus, you take a bonus, $2,000. Will you be happy? I'll be happy. Honestly, I'll be happy. I'll take it. Then Allah is giving you a bonus for a simple act on that day. Then, the Prophet والسلام, on the last year, he went to Hajj. He did only one Hajj, by the way, the Prophet والسلام, only one. Then, do we have to do it every year? One of the Sahaba went to the Prophet, should we do Hajj every day, every year? And the Prophet didn't respond. And the Sahabi said again, should we do it every year? And the Prophet didn't respond. And he said, again for the third time, should we do it every year? And the Prophet looked at him and said, alayhi salatu wasalam, he said, if I say yes, lawajabat. If I say yes, it will be a mandatory on everyone. And you will not be able to do it. You will not be able to do it. Then really the Prophet is kind of giving us all the glad tidings. Try. If you cannot afford it, it's okay. لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. You cannot, by the way, because I heard some of the new shuyukh saying that I can get some money and go and do Hajj. No. If you can afford saving money, then you can go. If don't get borrow money from the bank to go and do Hajj. Because you don't know when you're going to pay this money. First, because you can go and die. Then you go meet Allah owing this amount of money. No. Even some of the ulama are saying if you have dain, any dain, you cannot go. You have to pay the dain first. Dain, which means what you owe anyone. Except if he tells you, this person, I forgive you. If you die, you're gone. It's okay. I forgive you. Then yes. It's very strict, by the way. And this is the only pillar that you have to do it while you can. You can physically and emotionally and money-wise. Especially these days, it's too expensive. Too expensive. I'm not sure it's turning to be something else. But anyway, this is not the khutbah today. Next, what should we do? Should we do? The Prophet والسلام, on the last, on Arafah, he started giving the people the guidelines of how we live in our lives. All your blood is not accepted. No one should kill no one. إِنَّ دِمَاءَكُمْ وَأَعْرَاضَكُمْ عَلَيْكُمْ حَرَامٌ. All أَعْرَاض means my family, my money, everything. أَعْرَاض means what you have, what you own. No one should steal that. No one. حرام. You cannot touch. And then the Prophet والسلام, dropped interest. By the way, some people would say, is this the interest of today or not? I'm not a alim, I'm not a sheikh, I cannot respond to that now. But leave it for the sheikh to respond, hopefully they will talk about it. But the interest, what he's talking about, if I give you for food, that's what I understand. But this is not, I'm not a sheikh to give a fatwa of that. Then, One of my kids asked me a question. Father, how the ladies and men are going around and here in the masjid we segregate them. I told her that when someone goes there, his head is not in this thing. Touch girl or touch a woman. No, your head is you want Allah to forgive. You go there, all what your intentions are, acceptance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then really your head is not there at all. Your head, and I told her the hadith, immediately it came to my head that the Prophet ﷺ talking again, remember the hereafter. The Prophet ﷺ said everyone will go naked in the hereafter. No one, no clothes on any of us on the hereafter. And really, if you think about it a little bit, I'm saving, I'm holding, I'm covering. Now I'm exposed. And her mother Aisha got it and said, oh Prophet, and everyone is watching everyone, men and women and everyone. And the Prophet understood what's behind the question. And he said, Al-amru akbaru min thalik. When you go to Hajj and I saw people dying in front of you, dying in front, immediately, died in front of you, cannot do anything to him, gone down. And they ran to him, CPR, gone. Really, life is so nothing. We're fighting for nothing. He's gone. But may Allah make us like him, die in his way. Die on praying or making sujood or reading the Quran. On his way, not on a ma'asiyah, doing bad thing. May Allah make us all accept it, inshallah. Then, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said to everyone, did I deliver the message? Ala hal ballaght? And he's talking to everyone in front of him. Ala hal ballaght? And the sahaba said, yes. And he repeated again, ala hal ballaght? I said, yes. Ala hal ballaght? And he said, yes. And he pointed to them and he pointed to Allah. Allah, my witness, I delivered. The prophets will be questioned. Every one of us will be questioned. Did you deliver to your kids? Did you deliver to your family? Everyone is responsible for his family. Did you deliver to your family? Don't worry about John across the road now. Yeah, we want him to join. But I'm scared about Muhammad in my house. Ahmed in my house. This is what I'm scared about. Yeah, and everyone should be. I'm worried about Fatma in my house. Are they on the right path? Are they? Did you do your job? That's the question to every one of us. This is the 10 days that we have to do extra work. Bring your kids with you. Bring everyone with you. Try. The Prophet did extra work on these 10 days. SubhanAllah, these are the 10 days and for extra work, and then inshallah we'll see you on Rajab when Rajab starts, 6 months. Then really, this is the bonus that we cannot miss. Sorry, there's Muharram too, I'm sorry. I missed, inshallah. I'll talk about Muharram when it comes, inshallah. May Allah forgive us all. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر عليكم فاستغفروا يا فوز المستغفرين. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. أما بعد, I'll talk about quickly about the end of month, which is the beginning of الهجرة. And when did it start? It started when the Prophet was migrating from Mecca to Medina. And the Sahaba started from Muharram, because this is after Hajj. The people come to Hajj and they started. Sayyidina Umar, when did it start? It started when Sayyidina Umar thought that we need a calendar. We need our own Islamic calendar. And if I ask the youth and some of the adults, do you know the Islamic calendar? Do you know the month in the Islamic calendar? I'll be surprised. I'll be surprised if some of you will know it. Some of you will not know it. You have to learn it. Teach your kids about it. Sayyidina Umar wanted to do that, and one of our cousins came to him and said, there is an ayah in the Quran that if we have it, we will make it a celebration day. And Sayyidina Umar said, which ayah are you talking about? He said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. This is what revealed when? In Mecca. In Arafat. That's how beautiful. And Sayyidina Umar said, I know where it was. It was in Mecca, on Arafat, on that day. Like they call it Al-Hajj Al-Akbar. The Prophet said, Islam is done on that day. No more increasing on it. Then, quickly, what should we do? Again, you should try to do extra work on these 10 days, starting Monday. Try to do extra work. Two, try to fast at least يوم عرفة. Is it a sunnah to fast the 10 days? No, ulama saying that. No, nothing narrated. But siyam is a sunnah. You can do it if you want. Three, try to come to Eid prayer. And inshallah, like I said, next week, inshallah, I'll say what should we do, should be doing an Eid here, inshallah. Four, try to bring everyone to Eid. Enjoy. Five, try to take that day off. Especially the people who are working. Try to ask your manager to take it off on that day, Wednesday. If it's Eid, try to take it off. Why? Have a vision. After maybe 20, 30 years, our grandkids, when they can ask the government that it will be a real celebration day. I said before, I met someone in the Walmart and she said that I cannot take that day off because my manager doesn't like it. And really, I felt I cannot help her. I cannot. Because really, yeah, I know the rules, but after a while he can fire her. And not related to that, something else, and he said she's out. She knows that, and we know that. But the problem is, we need to try to legalize it. This is very important. Have a vision to join. Bring your family. Take them out. Make that day rememberable. If you have young kids, young grandkids, make it rememberable. Everyone will remember that day. Every one of my kids remember Christmas, and even, wallahi, the songs of Christmas. When it comes, they know it. My kids, I'm talking about my kids, not others, my kids. They remember it. Oh, because why? Every year they hear it. Every year they see it. Every year they know it. They memorize it by heart. How can, and they tell them, haram, 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 okay, haram, okay, haram. And they agree, some of them agree, some of them don't. But really, what should we do? Now we have Eid coming. Bring them in. Celebration day. Help. Take off that day. Try your best. Lastly but not least, try to smile. Extra smile. Extra fun. Extra everything extra. Not extra, extra enjoyment. Extra smiling. Extra happiness. That day is a happy day. Try to make it as happy as possible. One last thing I remember now. On that day, on Tuesday, Yom Arafah, try. Alhamdulillah, Maghrib prayer is at 9 now. No one tell me I'm at work, except if you're on a shift. But 9 o'clock, try to bring all your family. Let's have iftar. You remember when we have it in Ramadan? Everyone was coming after iftar. Wallahi, I love this month. Everyone is trying his best to come to iftar. It's a good excuse. On Tuesday, Yawm Arafat, let's sit with each other and make iftar. With each other, with the family, and talk and chat and enjoy. Very important to have the family wise, because this is the buildup of our family. اللهم اهدنا في من هديت اللهم اهدنا في من هديت وعافنا في من عافيت اللهم اجمعنا ولا تفرقنا اللهم اغفر لنا ولوالدينا ولمن سبقنا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم اللهم اجعلنا من المقبولين واجعلنا من ورث جنة النعيم اللهم تقبل منا رمضان اللهم تقبل منا رمضان اللهم تقبل منا رمضان واجعلنا من عبادك السعداء في الدنيا والآخرة يا رب العالمين وآخر دعوانا الحمد لله رب العالمين وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
حقا يا سامي حقا لا إله إلا الله جزاك الله خير استووا تراصوا اعتدلوا For the youth, inshallah, try to plan to come to give khutbah. I want everyone, inshallah, the youth are our generation, inshallah. Jazakum la khair. Stawu, tarassu, i'tadilu. الله أكبر. اللهم بعد بيني وبينك بعد أبنا مش منهم ونقني من الثرى فأخذ من الثرى وأثر وأخذ ولا مش مسمع. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. كم يحب ربي ورده. الله أكبر. اللهم اغفر لنا وصرفنا في أمنا في ناصرين. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. اللهم اغفر لنا وصرفنا في أمنا في ناصرين. الله أكبر. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. لم يحب ربي ورد. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الصلوات والطيبات السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. استغفر الله من حقمة تبر. استغفر الله من حقمة تبر. استغفر الله من 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 استغفر الله